If you type ifconfig, it will display IP address information and other information about the interface like MAC address and broadcast and netmask and etc. And if you notice here, the Ethernet device name is ENP0S3, which means Ethernet peripheral device. So EN stands for Ethernet. P0 means it's a PCI location or bus number 0, and S3 is a serial number or slot number. So ENP0S3 means it is Ethernet device connected to bus number 0 and serial number 3. And you can also use IP address so command to view the IP address information. You can also use the short version IP address so or IP address so. And if you want to see the IP routing table, IP route so or IP route so or IP route so. And to see the link state of device, if the device is up or down, you can use IP link so or IP link so. And if you do host name, it will display the host name of the system. So we discussed these commands in detail in one of my previous video. And since these commands and tools are common to almost all Linux distros, we are not going to repeat them here, but I'll put a link of the video on the top right corner so that you can go and check it out later if you want to. The link should appear at any moment now. And in that video, which I just linked on the top, we also discussed about how to configure network interface to get IP address and DNS information using DHCP and static method in the latest Ubuntu 20.10 server. And today we're going to talk about network tools and commands for IP configuration specific to the latest Red Hat Enterprise Linux 8. I'm using Red Hat Enterprise Linux 8.4. Red Hat and CentOS share same tools and commands, and they both use Network Manager CLI and text user interface to configure IP address information. So you can take the reference from Red Hat and use it on the latest CentOS as well. We can see the status of Network Manager daemon by typing systemctl status Network Manager. So the daemon is active and running. And nmcli is the command, Network Manager command line interface. And if you do connection show, it will give you the list of connection that has been created in the system. So ENP0S3 is for the Ethernet device, and another one is the virtual bridge. They both have their own unique identifier and type and the device name. So this connection here, ENP0S3 for Ethernet device, is a DHCP connection. And today we are going to create another DHCP and a static connection and assign IP address manually. And in short, you can also do nmcli connection. So if you want to filter the connection for a particular connection, you can do connection show P0S3. A lot of information about that particular connection. And if you want to get IP address and DNS and gateway information from that information, you can use grep nmcli connection show P0S3 and do grep. Let's do case insensitive IPv4.method. That will show you if this is a static connection or DHCP connection. So auto means it's a DHCP connection. And if you do nmcli connection show grep IP4, yes, that'll give you IP address information. And you can also do multiple. Let's do egrep for filtering the expression and or IP gateway or IP4 DNS. So here, if you noticed, we used IPv4.method to display whether it's a DHCP or a static connection. But when we display IP address information, it's IPv4 address, IPv4 gateway, and IPv4 DNS. And we can use IP link set device ENP0S3 down. So that will take the device down and it will not have any IP address anymore. And that connection is down now. So now let's add another DHCP connection using nmcli command. And the command is nmcli connection add connection name. We can give get DHCP IP and type is Ethernet and interface name is ENP0S3. And the method is auto for DHCP. Let's list the connection now. And we can create a static connection using the same command. Get static IP would be the name. Ethernet interface name is also same. And now we will define IP address. So IP4 and address is, let's say, 172.16.10.5/24. And IPv4 gateway is 172.16.10.1 and IPv4 method is manual here. that connection is added, and you can use nmcli connection. So we have enp0s3 DHCP connection, which was created when the system was installed. Get DHCP IP we just created, and get static IP is the static connection that we just created. So device does not have IP address information now. And now let's enable the DHCP connection that we just created. So the command is nmcli connection up get DHCP IP. It will try to get the IP address. Now IP address, so, and it has 172.16.10.42 as the new IP address. We do nmcli connection, so that connection is active. And if you want to activate the static connection, then nmcli connection up get static IP. And now that is activated. And now the interface has static IP address that we just assigned using nmcli command. We created network connections using nmcli connection add command. We can also modify the properties of connection by using nmcli connection modify command. So let's try that. We have only assigned IP before address and gateway information for this get static IP connection that we just created. And we have not added DNS information. So we can use nmcli connection modify command to add DNS information as well. So if you do nmcli connection, so get static IP and get IP for address, you'll see the IP address, but it does not have DNS information. So let's add DNS information as well. And the command is nmcli connection modify. Name of the connection is get static IP and ipv4.dns. So if you notice here, while we're adding a network connection, we just used ip4.address, but while modifying the parameters for an existing connection, we used ipv4 instead. So this is not a typo, it did just a syntax, and this is how it works. And now if we go and run this command again, let's set the interface down. Now it has a DNS address information. And to add a second item for the same parameters, we have to use plus sign. So we can do nmcli connection modify get static IP plus ipv4.dns and give the IP address for secondary DNS server. So let's set the link down again and get the link up. Now we have two DNS addresses. You can also add secondary IP address using the same command, nmcli connection modify get static IP is the name of the connection, plus ipv4 instead of ip4.address, addresses 172.16.10.6, for example. Let's set the link down and let's turn the connection off. Now we have two IP addresses for the interface. And if you want to change the IP address, you can use the same command, but you don't have to use the plus sign. Let's make it 8. Set link down, turn the connection up, and filter the IP address information. Now the IP address is 10.8 instead of 10.5. Let's activate the DHCP connection. And this should give us a different IP address information and DNS information. So what this command actually did is it repeated the last command, but replaced the get static IP with get DHCP IP. Pretty cool feature. And you can see the command here. So the same command is this one, but it just replaced this get static IP with get DHCP IP. I talked about this command and many other history related commands in one of my video, and I'll also link that video on the top if you want to learn more about history command. So far we discussed a network manager command line interface tool, and Red Hat also provides network manager text user interface tool, and we can access it using nmtui command, network manager text user interface. It is similar to graphical user interface, but it's a text based, so you can actually edit a connection and change the information, or you can actually add a new one. Connection name, let's say static TUI device ENP0S3. And when you come to automatic, you can actually hit enter and change the type. So let's keep it automatic for now. Everything automatic. And okay. So this is the connection that we just added. And if you click on this one, we'll get the information about that connection. Let's cancel it. And now we can go back and quit. CLI connection show. Now we have this new DHCP connection that we just created using NMTUI, Network Manager Text User Interface. So if I do ifconfig, it is a DHCP through get DHCP IP connection. And let's do IP address information. And let's turn, even though we said static, we made DHCP connection. That's fine. And we got the IP address again from DHCP. And if you are not sure about connection command, you can actually hit tab and get all the help. So connection, name, test, and then space, hit tab, and then it will give you more options. So if you're not comfortable using this command, you can actually use nmtui command, text-based user interface, and even RHCSA exam allows you to use it. So you should be good on that part as well. So this is it for this video, and I hope this video was helpful to you, and I'll come up with another video next week. And until then, take care and see you soon.